I'm going to describe here how to use a psychrometric chart, which is also known as humidity chart. And what I'm going to do is show you how to get things like dry bulb temperature, relative humidity, moisture content, the fraction or the ratio of kilograms of water per kilograms of dry air, the dew point temperature, enthalpy, the human air volume, specific volume, and wet bulb temperature. And to make this clear, what I'm going to do is take advantage of an online interactive simulation for psychrometric charts, and I've given the location here. So what I'm going to do now is switch over and look at that interactive simulation and then describe these various properties on the chart. So here is what a psychrometric chart typically looks like, though usually we don't see it with various colors, but it looks complicated. So what I'm going to do is remove a number of the things, add these back in as we discuss them. Let's remove the grid lines. And normally we don't display those temperature values that are shown. Let's move specific volume and let's remove enthalpy. And so here's a real basis of the psychrometric chart. We're showing temperature on the x-axis and moisture content, kilograms of water per kilograms of dry air. In this particular simulation, we can change the temperature, and this is the dry bulb temperature, and that means the actual temperature of the air if we had a thermometer in the air. And I can move, you notice, along a relative humidity line, and I can change the relative humidity. So saturation line is here. That's as much moisture as we can have in air at equilibrium. And then this is 90, 80, 70, etc. percent of saturation. So now what we want to do is we want to look at relative humidity at about 28%, and the temperature is about 35 degrees C. So I'm going to display, and it's showing three temperatures. This is the dry bulb temperature. This is the dew point temperature. And the dew point temperature corresponds to how much do I have to cool down this air. I'm not changing the moisture content, so whatever moisture is in there stays in there until I get to saturation. And this means if I cooled any lower, I would start condensing out water. That's the dew point. Here is the wet bulb temperature. This is the temperature if I were to wrap, for example, cloth around a thermometer and then move it through the air, I'd get evaporative cooling. Water would evaporate because we're not at saturation conditions. Water would evaporate. This would cause cooling because energy for evaporation comes from lowering the temperature. And that temperature I measure would be the, and let me display the values, would be the wet bulb temperature. So the wet bulb temperature is 21 degrees. That's something I can measure. Dew point is 14 degrees. And the wet bulb temperature corresponds fairly closely, not exactly, but here that's what we're going to approximate as along a constant enthalpy line. So I've added in the enthalpy line so we can read the enthalpy now, 59 kilojoules per kilogram. This is, of course, for some reference conditions, which are typically the same for the charts you're going to find in books. So I can read the enthalpy because everything along this blue line has the same enthalpy. And let's remove this so it's not too complicated, and let's look at specific volume. So for this point, specific volume, or humid volume, it's probably a better term, is number of cubic meters per kilogram of dry air. So 0.94 cubic meters per kilogram of dry air. I can look in as I change relative humidity, I can see how these various values change. So let me add these in. So now I'm displaying the values and this simulation, I can change the relative humidity or I can change the temperature and observe changes in the various values that can be, of course, read off the chart. And of course, this is more typically how the chart would look. So hopefully this gives you a good introduction of how to use a psychrometric chart to get information about air that has moisture that's below saturation.